You know, it would be a shame to not go for a swim while we're here, wouldn't it? I'm so shook right now. I didn't bring a swimsuit. Then swim in your underwear? Hey little angels, it's Madison Pajaro, and today I'm going to be playing episode, my little part two version. Version, what am I talking about? It's not a version, it's just my part two to the part one, I guess. But pretty much I'm going to just be playing episode today, guys. So yeah, this is like a little one. This one that I'm doing is only like a 5-part one, like there's only 5 episodes to it. So if you haven't watched this one, I will leave the first one in the end screen, so I'll put like a little tag and everything, so. Oh, let me know guys down below if you like this like look I have going on. I don't know why, like I'm not wearing foundation right now, but I don't know, like my makeup's very minimal today, but I like it, you know. But yeah guys, if you do end up liking this video, please give it a big thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, turn on your post notifications, and let's get right into this video. Okay, so the one that we're playing guys is called the Enchantress, so it's really cute. It's right here, it's so adorable. Okay, I'm gonna start it now. Let me cut on the volume. Oops. I'm kind of excited to see where like this goes, you know, let me scooch a little bit. The music on this is really cute. I'm telling you, Jake, he went from practically laughing at me and probably thinking I'm some nut job or something to suddenly flirting with me in front of my mom. Literally schmood. You guys have to watch part one if you're over here trying to watch this one. Go watch part one or you really truly will not understand, because this story is like kind of different than most episodes. I would have paid to have seen that. They're so freaking cute together. So how's your hand doing? A lot better actually. I barely feel it now. I guess the antibiotics worked. Zach, over here. Oops, are you literally kidding me, bro? You guys know how I feel about Zach. Like, I don't like his ass. Hey man, people usually apologize for knocking someone down like that. Why should I apologize? I did it on purpose. He's everything I don't like in men. Everything I don't like in men. Wow, you really are a douche. Apologize now. Hey, apologize, Zach. Jake, just forget it. He's not worth it. Oh, wow. Oh wow, this guy's shook. Hello, are you even listening? Oh hey, Eva, didn't see you there. Oh hell no, don't give us that bull. You knocked her to the freaking ground. What? I could never do that to such a delicate flower. What the heck? What? What the hell, Zach? You smell nice. Has anyone told you that? Zach, run the f*** along. What is this about? Nothing, you're cute when you get nervous. Okay, what? Right? What the heck? I'll see you around, gorgeous. I'm like, please don't call me that. Thank you. What the hell was that about? You saw that too, right? He's probably just taking his douchiness to the next level by fake complimenting you. I'm gonna put maybe there's more to it. What do you mean? Oh, sorry, my choices were maybe there's more to it, or you're right, like there's nothing going on, I think. But Jake said, what do you mean? I wouldn't be surprised if they're plotting something even meaner. I wouldn't either, so just be careful with him. He's a snake. For sure. It's weird. He commented on how I smell too, just like the doctor. Do I smell different to you? I haven't changed my perfume or anything. No, to me you smell like coconuts, like you've always done. Men are weird. Facts. I couldn't stop thinking about Zach's recent change of demeanor. It was so abrupt, just like the doctors behaved that day before. I hadn't changed anything about myself. I looked and talked the way I always did. It had to be nothing more than a freaky coincidence. I mean, what else could it be? Since my hand was feeling better, the mysterious flower was slowly moving to the back of my mind. After all, I had a contest to win, and I knew I couldn't dwell on the fact that I lost the chance to get an epic photo of it. I forgot about the contest. I'm so shook. I wonder what's gonna happen with that. So like any other driven young woman, I started to think about where else I could get my extraordinary photo. And then it hit me. Are you up for a little adventure after school? Oh no. Oh my gosh. They're so cute. They like travel with each other a little bit. Like it's so adorable. the 4 mile path to the Scared Falls, or no, not scared, sorry, Sacred Falls is so dangerous, it's officially off limits. But we went there anyways, hoping to get my contest winning photo. That's honestly really dumb, to be honest, like, I wouldn't do that. Okay, I think we're almost there. Why are we risking getting squashed under giant falling rocks for this waterfall? For real, like, what? This is Hawaii, you could go like anywhere to see it, or to see a waterfall. I mean, what's so amazing about it? The judges aren't just looking for an extraordinary photo, Jake. They're looking for an extraordinary explorer. And not just an explorer, but also an extraordinary story behind every picture. We're trespassing to get here, risking our lives for it. That's just what they're looking for. This woman. Yeah, I just love risking my life for your contest. Okay, I can pick encourage him or dare him. I'm gonna dare him. Oh, come on, you said you'd work for it as well, remember? You kinda have something to prove, Jakey. I've risked my life twice now, what more can I do? How about stop complaining and get moving? You're unbelievable, Oz. They are meant for each other, because he like deals with her shit, you know? What? Do you hear that? That rumbling sound. Here, let me cut up. The waterfall hike was illegal for a reason. It's situated within a canyon surrounded by huge mountains, which makes the probability of a landslide or flash flood really high. I don't think we should go here. If it gives me an option, I'm not gonna go here. Thunder, perhaps. The rumbling was getting closer. We could trace the sound to further up the mountainside. That's when we saw a giant boulder plunging down the mountain. No, I don't want to hit the butt. Okay. It was heading straight towards us. Eva, run. Jake did everything he could to push me to safety. He threw his body on top of mine to shield me from boulders. What the heck? This is getting intense now. Holy cow. Eva, are you okay? Ugh. My God, that was so close. Whoa. Dang, they would have been killed, bro. They would have been long gone. Okay, the boulders plummeted to the ground where we had just been standing. We only barely made it. Okay, I can pick thank Jake for protecting you. Apologize for putting him in danger. I would apologize because it was kind of like her fault that they were there. Okay, Jake, I'm so sorry for putting you in danger. I should have listened to you. I knew the risk when I agreed to come with you. Don't beat yourself up. You're alive and well. Now let's go get your picture. I remember feeling warm inside. Jake did everything in his power to protect me. She's starting to like him. Oh my God, she's starting to like him. I didn't even dare to imagine what would have happened if he hadn't been there. He just saved my life and he was acting like it was nothing special. I like Jake. You guys know I like Jake. Got a little something for him. Got a little thing for him. Okay, Eva said, this is stunning. It is. Are you going to use it for the first round of the contest? Definitely. I think Clarity Jones, one of the judges, will love it. I also have to find a way to impress the wildlife expert too. Tim Atticus is his name, I think. You know, it would be a shame to not go for a swim while we're here, wouldn't it? I'm so shook right now. I didn't bring a swimsuit. Then swim in your underwear? Okay, I get it, like they're best friends and everything, but like, oh my gosh. No, nothing is worse than wet clothes while hiking. It's painful, actually. Then swim naked. I'm sorry, what, Jake? Is it weird that I'm not even creeped out by you suggesting that? Me either. Heck, I'll do it too. Long live solidarity, right? Oh my gosh, you guys know we have to go skinny dipping. Thank you. Let's do this. Okay, let's do it. Last man is a rotten egg. A first man in has to eat it. What? Jake has always been the only guy I felt comfortable around, except for my dad. Obviously even comfortable enough to go skinny dipping with him. He gets me and we've known each other ever since we were toddlers. That is so freaking cute. You know they're gonna end up together. You just know it. His family moved here a year before we did. Oh my gosh, she just swam right by it, you know what I'm saying? And since our dads work together and always have been friends, It was Jake's dad who talked my dad into taking the job here. Our families being so close and both of us being transplants, it's only natural we become friends. He's so dear to me. Wait, did it say transplants? And if so, why? Okay, I just paid 10 gems for that. Are you joking? Like, it's starting now, Eva. What is? The judges from the Capturelt contest are on Laura Levine. Hello and welcome back to Tonight with Laura Levine. I'm Laura Levine and I'm here with judges from the Capturelt contest. Capturelt? World known photographer and journalist Miss Clarity Jones. Explorer, veterinarian, and wildlife expert Dr. Tim Atticus. And and last but not least, the man behind it all, Mr. Michael Monarch, CEO of Monarch Cruises, or Monarch, whatever you guys want to, however you guys want to pronounce it. If you're one of the 200,000 registered contestants for the contest, then there are the people you need to impress. Miss Jones, what does it take to impress you? I have a sharp eye for the story behind the picture. I want to feel what the photographer felt when he took it. Make it obvious to me that you have originality, talent, skill, and passion, and I'll be impressed. Interesting. How about you, Dr. Atticus? Well, I only need to see some big, dangerous animals to be impressed. And of course, you gotta show us what you want. You gotta show us that you want this. Do something daring and challenge yourself. Do something daring. You heard it from the daredevil himself. Lastly, Mr. Monarch, what does it take to impress you? The point about this contest is to find the best match for the job, so it's very simple. Be yourself, don't pretend to be something you're not, just be yourself. I like him. Great advice, don't forget, you heard it first from here, Laura Levine. Thanks for watching. This was it, the first round of the Capturelt contest. I knew to win this, I had to impress each and every one of the three judges. I did my research and had an idea of what the judges would look like, is that what it said? But now I'm sure of what they're looking for individually. I hope Clarity Jones will be impressed by the picture. She's my idol. Done. Now I can only hope for a lot of likes on my picture. If I was going to win out over 200,000 other contestants, I'd have to get noticed. There was a top 5 most liked pictures page. I knew that if I could get in the top 5, the judges would for sure have seen my picture. I made note of the judge's comments in my head. I needed to figure out how to impress Tim Atticus next. That's the guy who liked the animals, so. Hey Jake, what's up? Eva, I just came across something I think you could use for the contest. You said one of the judges were a wildlife expert, right? Yes, what is it? Tell me. No time to explain, just get down here. Okay, I'll be there in 10. Great, oh, and Eva, just to warn you, Kiana and the others are down here. Ugh, great. And Kai's with them. A mysterious photo opportunity and I get to see Kai. I'm so there. Thanks, Jake. See you there. This is gonna be like a tiger or something. This would be like a dangerous animal. I need to get changed first. I could dress up a bit, wear something that will make Kai notice me. Not that I have anything like that, but I do have a stylish sister who's an aspiring fashion designer. I'm sure Emma won't mind if I borrow this outfit. Show me the outfit. I don't even really like that outfit, to be honest. Like, that's not me. I like the shoes. The bracelets are cute. But I don't like the shirt or the shorts. They made it look like it was like the best outfit ever. That's a cute outfit, but how many, 15? Should we do that? Let's see the other ones. If they're ugly, we'll do that one. Oh, heck no. No. Casual. That's kind of cute. Oh, but she wore it earlier. Whatever. You know they just want me to spend some gems. Whatever. We'll spend... Oh, I didn't mean to click that. Yeah, you're right. I don't want to spend gems on this. I'm going to just do casual. Why not? It don't matter. It's a video game. It will do. Y'all just want my money. Better get going. Okay, I'm here. What is it? I think it's happening soon, I'll show you. But we have to walk past Zach, your lover boy, and the triplets first. Let's get it over with then. This should be nice to her though, right? Oh, look who it is. Ew, and Scarface. I don't remember inviting you. Yeah, well, it's public beach, Kiana, but relax. We're just passing through. Yeah, right. I can smell it when the desperate losers are trying to mingle with us. Ew, she's everything you shouldn't be in a girl. Don't be so rude, Kiana. Of course, they're welcome here. Hey, how you doing, Eva? Ew, that makes me uncomfortable. What's wrong with you, Zach? I think I've been bitten by the love bug. Cut it out, Zach. I'm not falling for your stupid act. Yeah, Zach, just let go. I'm not acting. I'm serious. Eva is not like the other girls. Even if it was true, it wouldn't matter because she's only interested in Kai. She knows? Oh, no. Now it's only a matter of time before the whole school knows. It's not even that big of a deal, to be honest. She's not even denying it. She's just awkwardly frozen, as per usual. Usual. Oh, it's gonna be the hottest gossip topic tomorrow in school. And then Kai's not saying anything. See, that's how you know she shouldn't be with Kai. Because, like, Kai should be saying something at this point. I've had a crush on Kai for 3 years, and now it's all going to be ruined. Why? It's been 3 years. It's about time someone says some shit for you. Oh, that's it. That's the whole thing, I guess. I'm assuming. Yeah, to be continued. Okay, guys, so this episode was, like, way more intense than the last one. Like, I like this episode a lot better. I can't wait to film part 3. I'm so excited to see what happens in this story. If you guys did like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. Hit the subscribe button, turn on your post notifications. Thank you guys so much for watching my video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I love you guys so much, and I'll see y'all in my next one. Bye, guys! What I am trying to say.